So for our next video series, we decided to ask our consumers and our past clients what they wanted us to talk about. So we put a Facebook post out there and said, what questions can we answer for you with regard to real estate? So we got 6 responses, and so those are the questions that we're going to be discussing here in the next couple of videos.
Marianne, the first question is, most sellers will want to know, of the 3 questions, the first one is, how much is my house worth?
It's much more complicated than it appears, because it varies significantly by geography, it varies significantly by what product we're selling, and it can vary by time of year, and certainly varies by condition. So price, condition, location are the 3 things that drive what a home actually sells for. So from the standpoint of location, if you have a 4-bedroom, 2.5-bath home in a suburban neighborhood where virtually all the homes are 4 bedrooms, 2.5 baths, that's a pretty straightforward analysis. But oftentimes we are selling homes that can be very old. They could have been modified numerous times. There could be neighborhoods where there's homes that are worth $200,000 and homes that are worth $2 million, all in the same neighborhood. So it's a little more complicated. We like to see the house before we give an opinion of market value. And then we do a lot of due diligence to make sure that when we are talking about a price range, that we have taken into consideration as much data as possible. So our opinion of market value is largely based on a lot of research, due diligence, and data-driven as much as we possibly can.
Excellent.
My second question is, what are the hottest markets for appreciation in Cincinnati and why?
The hottest markets tend to be in areas where things follow what the consumer is looking for in today's market. Walkability, close to retail, sidewalks, and homegrown communities. We've seen Oakley, Hyde Park, Mount Lookout, in some areas in over the Rhine and downtown be very hot markets over the last 2 to 3 years, and we anticipate that continuing. The new construction tax abatement program that the city of Cincinnati has also has lent itself to allowing that to be the case in those markets. Last question, the third question that sellers ask us on a regular basis is, what are you gonna do to sell my home? I understand what the price might be. I understand based on the price, it may take longer or a shorter period of time. Third question is, what are you going to do as the Ries team to sell my home?
So we have a marketing plan that is largely geared around the way consumers find their homes. So the National Association of Realtors does a survey annually to find out what is making people buy a specific home, or how are they getting exposed to their home that they actually purchase. And there's really 4 key factors. The first one is the internet. And so we spend a lot of time and resources on making sure that our listings have the best possible internet presence. So the first thing we do is we have a professional photographer come and photograph the properties. That is a really good investment for us, because there are lots of photographers that run around. They have 15 or 20 minutes at each house. They take a lot of pictures. You'll see a lot of ceilings. You know, 50% of the picture is the ceiling.
Ceilings and hallways.
And hallways. So we really put a lot of emphasis on that professional photographer. And then from an internet standpoint, we subscribe to a product that forces the listing out to 900 different real estate websites. So not only are you on Zillow and TruliaRealtor.com and all of the real estate websites in your market, but there are literally hundreds of real estate websites, and we wanna make sure that no matter what a consumer is looking at, they're gonna see your house. We also have a social media campaign. We have a video that we put together to ensure that people see the property. And then we also do a specific website for each listing to make sure that people that are looking, they drive by a house, they write down the address, and they Google it, there is a website dedicated to that listing. So from an internet standpoint, we really try to cover all the bases. The second most common way that people find their homes is through their real estate agent. So we actually directly market to other agents. Coming soon, open house, any kind of price adjustment, anything that happens with that property, we want those agents that are looking for that product to know about it. The third most common way that people find their homes is through open houses. So that's about 2% nationally, but we sell 40% of our listings as a result of open houses.
Wow.
And we think that that really sets us apart from other real estate agents. So that's a huge factor for us. And then the fourth most common way that people find their homes is through signs. And so we make sure that wherever somebody's driving, they know that there's a house for sale back there, wherever that is, so that we guide them to the house so that they can see.
Right. I guess if the house is on the market and they can't find it, that's our problem,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
And we need to make sure that gets taken care of very quickly.
Yep.